Welcome back to Breaking the News. We have a pretty important update for you now from our investigative team, because there was a sentencing today in St. Paul in a double murder case that has wide-ranging implications. Here's AJ Legault with the latest in his long-running series, The Gap: Failure to Treat, Failure to Protect.
We'd like to show you what happened inside court today, but we can't. Judge Joy Barcher said media coverage does not bring transparency. Judge Barcher ignored the wishes of victims' families and refused to allow our cameras inside court for the sentencing of Joseph Sandoval.
Someone in the house with a bloody face.
October 20th, 2022.
Downstairs, and there's blood all over the place.
St. Paul police respond to a sober home.
The victim in basement unresponsive.
For a reported murder.
From the guy that we have in custody, it sounds like there might be two victims in the house.
There were two victims inside, killed with a knife and hammer. The man in custody, Joseph Sandoval. Carol Evans' Gap investigation, which led to sweeping changes of state law, exposed how Sandoval had a known history of severe mental illness, drug-induced psychosis, and violence. In one case, he stole a cab.
Holy s***!
Led police on a wild chase.
Southbound Portland.
Slammed into a pedestrian.
He just ran somebody right over.
Not once.
I'm a dude on the ground, and he drives directly for me.
But twice.
You think he was trying to kill you?
Yes.
Sandoval was repeatedly found incompetent to go to trial and was supposed to be civilly committed to the care of DHS because he poses a substantial likelihood of causing physical harm. However, he was released, sent to the outpatient treatment facility Evergreen Recovery, where, in one of their sober homes, he murdered two innocent men. Sandoval told police, "The TV said they were going to kill me and told me to take the opportunity."
It just doesn't make sense.
Marsha Murphy's son, Jason, was one of the victims. A handyman, he was working in the basement of the sober home. John Wentz, the other victim, was an Army veteran living at the home.
I'm not one to so much ask why all the time, but yeah, there's a lot of whys you could ask with this.
Evergreen Recovery is now under state and federal fraud investigations following Kara Levin's Recovery Inc. investigation that exposed allegations Evergreen systematically billed Medicaid for patient services not provided as claimed. Claims Evergreen owner David Backus denied.
That's absolutely false.
In court today, Joseph Sandoval's attorney said he was not getting the treatment he needed at Evergreen, and the system failed both the victims and Mr. Sandoval. Now restored to competency, Sandoval pled guilty to murders he says he can't even remember committing. He was sentenced to 38 years in prison. The victims' families remain with more questions than answers.
And hopefully maybe someday we'll have some answers.
Judge Barcher also issued what we believe to be an unconstitutional prior restraint against using records publicly filed on the court's website that deal with the treatment Mr. Sandoval received while he was at Evergreen Recovery. We're going to be challenging Judge Barcher's ruling in court. There's a whole lot more to this story that we're continuing to investigate, and we'll bring you the details in the coming weeks and months. For KARE 11 Investigates, I'm AJ Legault.
Thank you, AJ, so much. Well-